Far above Alaia and myself, giant powers feel a fold of time and matter soften round us, aching out a passage like they haven't felt before. They push and fill this passage out with cosmic enormity, then spin us in an arc that is greater than a galaxy but smaller than an atom, with an ecstasy beyond physicality, beyond mind or thought or the bars of time and matter. Here, beyond consciousness, we let these powers resonate, through my eyes and through her voice, and down through the stadium. The screen has grown to fill the sky. Each of the golden-grained cymbals of my irises is bossed with a perfect central black sun, in exquisite radiance of heavenly geometry. My lashes curl as long as constellations. My eyebrows sweep across the sky's northern hemisphere in thin black, sleekly-tapered arcs. Eyes and lips of a flame girl dissipating into air. And telescoped within the blinding grandeur of this face and voice, the turning of the Earth's nights and days shines divine through the vastness of space, while the years and aeons unpeel, billions of tons of rock and atmosphere and water on an orbit that is breakneck but luminously slow. The glance of the sun across the surface of the planet, through the whirl of its dawn around the volume of its sphere, lights the points of its peaks and the spumes of its waves in the tiniest of detail, in a sidelight that defies any labelling of colour. From the screen in the stadium, a flood of purple flame spreads, a fountain of unearthly colours, tastes, sounds, scents and ecstatic touch pours out from screens around the world, and the oceans rise a fraction. My face fades to black on screen. Alaia's voice fades out, and sound and vision glides to the smoothest of halts.